What do you think your future is looking like soon, come up 2020?
Yeah, a lot of interesting things cooking up in 2020. You know, I want to make the most of my season at Dallas. You know, whatever happens with, you know, future goals and everything, I hope they come. But right now my focus is on with Dallas and, you know, securing my spot on national team, challenging Yedlin, challenging Serginho, challenging Julian, you know, making my teammates around me better. That's my focus right now.
So securing that spot in the national team, do you think you have what it takes to be number one in your spot?
I believe it. You know, yeah. I look at Yedlin, I look at Serginho, and every time, you know, I play with them or against them, you know, they're always motivating me to get better, motivating me to change my style, to play my game, to up my level. You know, it's always it's a good thing when you have players around you that do that. So, you know, Yedlin and Serginho are obviously role models of mine, but, you know, I want to take the position.
You think that's a two-way street for them? You think they get a lot out of you, watching you play, watching you practice? Think it makes them better?
Oh, you know, I'm sure, like, we both get things out of each other, you know. They're both such confident guys, you know, playing in the Premier League and playing at Ajax, you know. I really look up to them, but at the same time, you know, I'm challenging them and I'm pushing them, and, you know, I know I can edge them out and I know I can push myself to be the best I can be.
You focus on Dallas, you said this year, but I mean, it's got to be a little bit tough. You know, there's rumors around. You've got a good future ahead of you. How do you stay focused on that?
Yeah, it's actually a good question. It's very tough, you know, with all the looming, you know, transfers and everything. You know, I'm just going to stay focused on Dallas because right now that's my priority and that's where I'm going to be. You know, if something happens, which it may, then, you know, I'll be focused on that. But right now, my focus is on national team and on Dallas.
Can you talk about last year you came out of January camp maybe feeling down about where you stood in the player pool and how you took the year to adjust, rise up, and, you know, as you said the other night, start and go to the final and make an impact through the end of the year?
Yes, it's something that's hard to talk about, but, you know, I always looked up to Nick Lima on that January camp. You know, he was a player that he, you know, I think when the word machine comes to mind, that's who first comes to mind, is Nick Lima. He was, you know, he never complained about what to do. You know, if Greg asked him to go in a certain position he wasn't comfortable with, he worked on it until he got it. And, you know, that was a little bit of motivation of mine. You know, that January camp, I wasn't quite ready to take that next step to the senior team under Greg. But, you know, Nick kind of motivated me to, you know, come inside in those spots and get uncomfortable and get out of my comfort zone to grow. You know, I attribute a lot of my success this year and last year to him.
For the young guys that are here, going through their first January camp, what are some of the things you think that they can take away and build off of that you learned last year?
Yeah, it's a tough month. You know, it's one of the hardest things to do as an MLS player, you know, being away from your family, your friends for a month. But it's all about having that mental strength and emotional strength I lacked last year in January camp. And again, that's growth. But, you know, look at Brian, Kyle, you know, getting called in at 17. I couldn't imagine getting called in the national team at 17, you know. And someone like that who needs maybe, you know, a Michael Bradley to kind of lead them down that path, I want to kind of be that, you know, that leader for them because I know what it takes. I know how hard it is, you know, when you're a rookie and when you're coming up. You know, I don't want to be looked at as a veteran yet, but, you know, I want to be that light for these guys that, you know, when it's tough, I want them to look up to.
And then you're age eligible for the Olympics this year, and obviously qualifying comes first. And you're in the thick of the first team with the senior team. Talk about how big of a year it could be for you.
Yeah, I think it's going to be a very big year. You know, Olympics is always something that, you know, you dream as a little kid to play in. Just like the World Cup, it's that big. And, you know, right now my focus is on with Dallas and, you know, improving things because I know in 6 months. It's going to be tough, and we're going to be playing some of the best teams in the world. I have no doubt that this team can qualify, and, you know, we have such a great young youth talent pool. So I think it's just going to be about coming together, learning each other's qualities, and playing off of it.